tilt is an option, especially if you're doing a back air timing like that in that close of a situation. Yeah, it's gonna get punished.
I think a lot of people just catch themselves overthinking about, oh, I just gotta worry about an air on shield. But that guy was Dragon.
And here on the other side of Winner's Top 8, we have JDV playing the Pac-Man, and we got NanoAsh on the Bowser. So, this is definitely one of the another classic matchup that we're used to seeing here in Washington.
A lot of our Washington matchup, very volatile, I would say.
Yes. I gotta say, big respect to NanoAsh for just running up and grabbing Pac-Man, who was just kind of sitting there charging his move.
Yeah, just, NanoAsh is just let it go.
He just kind of went for it. Okay, tries to kind of.
Man, Pac-Man has such good boxing tools, but this jab is gonna be massive.
It died!
Yep, that F smash is strong as Roy's F smash. You cannot underestimate it. It sends far.
And you don't need a hit of help. Sweet spot. It just kills.
It just kills.
Oh, well, Galaga on deck, but
JDV, but get the regrab. Whoa, what is going on with that? Whoa, what is going on?
Take me away to another place.
Okay. Oh, goes for that side. Be a little bit of that.
Just figure like, it's like.
Nice.
I like to spot him out. Bowser would want a seismic toss my ass right now.
Yeah.
Trying to go for the jab bait.
JDV understanding kind of some of the typical lead trap scenarios that NanoAsh kind of likes
kill,
to
kill, but get 132 and give NanoAsh like his lead trap scenario.
NanoAsh just let the side be ripped. I mean, that's really good
Galaga
against shielding, so.
No, that's definitely going to be a lot where I think NanoAsh is going to have to play, get the pickups here on the stocks. It's going to be coming from these ledge drop scenarios, but not finding the ins right now because, you know, if just getting the raw hit neutral is really, really hard for Bowser. A lot of it comes
Apple's
from.
On deck.
Ooh, hydrant. Hydrant's in your face.
Man, Ashwin's in a really tight spot, but.
Oh.
Where is the Bell? Oh,
I think Bell just despawned.
He just despawned. Oh, wow.
Ooh, down
smash. Despawning. Someone's got to respawn the Angel platform.
Yo,
right
I just saw NanoAsh look at his controller.
Yeah, the down smash media, unfortunate there.
Yeah.
Okay, there we go. That's finally going to do it, but.
I'll take it, but it's looking a little rough, but never forget that Bowser stock down is still even somehow. Sometimes.
Yep, that guy is one heavy guy. Tough guy, even.
I hate tough.
Okay,
right,
up
there.
Oh,
wow,
the
I like doing fair instead of nair.
I can understand that Bowser's a big body, so you probably have a little bit more wiggle room with what you can throw out.
Just
big bodies,
Bowser,
if you're comfortable with your
something.
Execution and you know your spacing, and
yeah.
A really fun combo food. They get to go a little crazy sometimes.
No, that's one of the things you gotta capitalize
really
to on
damage.
Heavies.
Yeah.
Whoa, so ends up working out.
When you get your hits, you just gotta push them as far as you can.
You have to respect your threat rate. Oh, down smash
gonna
catch a roll out.
Yeah, tech chasing there.
Melon.
No Galaga to stop this flame this time. That pushback, I'm still thinking about it.
Okay, puts JDV. I mean, like, even with, like, the, like, missing.
Are we gonna look to capture landing here?
The first two things.
Jumps into the hydrant, that's unlucky. Throwing off stage here.
Bell's in
I
play.
Like
he's not gonna sugarcoat it.
He's just not sugarcoating it.
You know, it was just a little bit too high.
Watch
with
out.
The float, but
and
that's
got
that door, yeah.
Whoa!
The
PS2 tax.
Bell is still out.
Oh, he can't do that against Pac-Man. When he throws a Bell down, that is active for a very long time. And JDV just so good at catching it and catches the neutral getup. F smashes, ends the game. What is this, game one?
This is game one.
That was game one.
EWGF takes that last stock. Pocket EWGF.
The original EWGF.
Yes. It's like the iPod Nano of EWGFs.
Going to Smashville.
Hatsune Miku doesn't know
it's
what that
precursor,
is.
The precursor, not as good.
I'm definitely throwing this wig away, by the way.
All right, we seem to be on it.
I can smell
now.
The leak from here still.
Yeah, the leak is overpowering.
Smashville pretty nice, because even if the hydrant between you and Bowser, there's not that much space between you and Bowser. So.
I've never seen JDV
use his skin before.
Use
what is
this?
Huh?
I don't
this
like this.
Is this even
new?
In the base game?
It's modded,
this
modded.
Is a modded.
What the heck is this?
I don't know, but he's black and yellow.
Black boots, black gloves, I guess.
I kind of fuck with it heavy though. I kind of like this all
a
lot.
It's kind of a vibe. I'm into it.
It should be really good percent for NanoAsh. Yeah,
I mean,
wow. At 93. Anything kills you, really.
Yeah, looking a lot different from game one.
Jeez.
NanoAsh building up momentum, but you do not. I'm not counting JDV out whatsoever.
No, you can never count JDV
out. One little string from JDV can even this up real quick or even take the stock. We saw it last game.
Yeah. I mean, slowly but surely chipping and racking up damage.
You have to play that nickel and dime game.
Tries to go for an air dodge read, go for that up smash, but not gonna find it. I love that.
Great Bowser Bomb.
Not gonna take stock, but
Now this is a good stage choice though. The forced interaction. There's a lot less space for JDB to kind of work with. And now she's definitely been taking advantage of that. But I mean, JDB slowly but surely has been racking up percent, bringing it back to even. But Bowser does find these kills a lot earlier. But we already got another bell in play. So Nanowash
has to here.
Be.
I ledge to, oh,
wow.
Barely avoids it with the get up attack. But you're still stuck in this ledge trap situation.
Yeah, JDB's got the setups though. He's ready to cover a lot of these. That's gonna be death.
Does this kill on the platform? It does, even on Smashville.
That was a bit of a greedy grab. That was like you're really going for you're kind of stretching going for that one.
With characters like Bowser, you just need to know that. Yeah, my turn is over. Let's not push it. But speaking of pushing it, you were pushing to the sky.
Yeah, for sure.
All right, some early percent for Nanowash. Oh, falling out of there. Great SDI. Going for these early combos by JDB. Yeah, as you said, the nickel and dime game. JDB plays it very well. Look at him, he's just throwing out planes, trying to find these early percents.
Yeah, it's kind of funny that on Smashville, like, JDB's interacting less now than he was on PS2. Like, I'm actually genuinely amazed that this is kind of how
he's just avoiding all these interactions.
Wow, there we go. That's a good black and double black combo.
Alright,
13% racked up, kind of like unmatched. Wow, three jabs from Bowser and break hydrant. That's actually kind
of
crazy.
Okay, we should do some good percent here. Yeah.
Crispy fingers. He's gonna get knocked back off stage though.
He does have crispy fingers.
Oh, Bell gets
re-grabbed. He has scorched hands.
Oh, really nice Bell from JDB.
The down toss Bell to kind of catch Bowser's massive hitbox coming up like that.
Yeah, I was about to say like that doesn't hit on anybody on the cast except Bowser's big fucking hands.
Big meaty claws.
Pause.
Those are claws.
Claws?
Santa? Hot to me.
Hey, what? What's going on?
I don't know. Oh, wow. The final hit
That was a little janky hitbox. I mean, Bowser's hit big fucking model. Like, it actually plays so much into the matchup more than I thought it would. Yeah, I mean, he's being pushed around by Hydrate. He's being pushed around by Bell. He's being pushed around by this plane.
Wow. Just the frame trap scenario
and
there.
The
ledge trap
coming out, too. Ooh, Hydrant gonna say you were staying
such
off stage.
Such an active hitbox, yeah. Holy. Bell's out. Oh, great catch by Nanowash, but not
but
finding
still looking
the
scary. JDB
catch.
Having his Hydrant due to ledge trapping and edge guard for him. Down smash.
Wow, JDB is covering
situation.
Every
out.
Option
one more Bell.
Right now.
Great catch. Nanowash is ready.
Yeah, you can't necessarily just go for the Z catch on the Bell because JDB
get the Hydrant out of the way.
Alright, Ashwin, he played really patient and gets rewarded for you. Now he's back on stage, ready to get this ledge trap ready. Key coming out. JDB gets back on stage three. It's looking a little more neutral, but JDB's hungry for this kill.
Melon.
And down air. Great place down air. Neutral get up. I mean, JDB, if you jump there, you know, you dodge neutral get up or you punish neutral get up and neutral get up attack, you know.
Miku, can you hand me my backpack on the other side of the couch?
Where is your bag? Is it this one?
It should be that one, yes.
JDB's playing a really nice nickel and dime game, it's really scary, especially on Smashville. Where,
that's the first time I've ever seen JDB approach.
Yeah, Bowser does not have to play nickel and dime, too, so...
Nah.
He kind of does. I mean, he has to wait until Pac-Man's off stage, get that flamethrower percent, and then pray to God that you get some ledge trap Pac-Man.
Yeah, but you get, like, two big booshes, and, you know, JDB's at 90.
No,
Bowser kills super early, but it's hard for Bowser to kind of get those situations like kind of conditioned
into
and set
favor,
up for him like actually get those hits.
Because then Bowser will just Bowser's gonna get nickel and dime.
Yeah,
and take that 45, that 50, that 60.
Yeah, like Bowser in this matchup relies a lot on these ledge traps so that like he can actually find his kills. Because you're not getting those hits in neutral, and you're not gonna be able to get off stage to kind of smack Pac-Man out there. But JDB's been playing phenomenally getting off of this ledge, either mixing up timings or having like something there to kind of
already corner, 40. So.
The double apple combo there, that was really well played by JDB and immediately countering back just to kind of rack up more percent to control the stage. There's gonna be a down throw, catches the tech.
Oh, dude.
Yeah.
92 already.
JDB
it's been 70
uses
seconds by the way.
Super well, even when it's just on play. He just goes aggro with it. He's not afraid to go out there.
I gotta say, JDB's always innovating. Like, he's always doing something new and unique. Ooh. It's never the same.
Yeah,
JDB
that ledge trap I haven't seen before. That down smash.
Got a recipe book. I don't know.
Bell's out. See, great catch. But Nanowash needs to catch these without air dodging in order to get the max, like, just get back on ledge safely. But JDB still has 0%. Oh my god, missing that grab barely.
Yeah.
JDB looking for this JV. That was bad. My bad.
There he goes.
We got
some percent on the board.
We got some percent on the board. It's looking good.
One step is a step. Now he's got to climb the rest of the
only
stairs.
Only steps forward, not steps backwards. But
180%. Ashwin, you got to start the game off a little bit better because you're down two games.
For some reason, I can just see Ashwin taking his first stock. I don't know why.
Why is...
Jose's struggling to find a kill right
now. Yeah.
Fruit's not active. Yeah, Fruit's still not here.
That's a lot of rage on a big, angry turtle.
Yeah,
I like the walk
there. Max rage now. 200% racked up, but yeah.
Yes,
bro,
it is
at 260%.
All right,
that still doesn't die here, but oh wait. Okay,
it's,
I guess like,
I
yeah,
you can just so lingering hitbox it because it just the bell angle sends him into it.
I think that's one of my favorite things about it. It looks raw.
Yeah, it's just very cool.
Wow, wait, he just capitalized off a flamethrower. Wait.
Yeah,
JDB,
he can do that?
JDB had the Galaxian in hand and took 51% from a situation that should have been disadvantageous towards him. And I think that's just like, it goes to show how phenomenally he's been playing. Just, you know, in this corner, like in these corner scenarios where either he has Ashwin in the corner or he's coming out of the corner himself. Like, he's just getting around it and managing so well. And it's definitely just been putting him.
Oh, wait, that was a weird interaction.
It's like the lead.
It's like Nanowatch wants. Like we were saying earlier, Nanowatch needs JDB to be on ledge. He needs to look for these ledge traps, but JDB has just been keeping Nanowatch at the ledge so he can never achieve that gameplay.
Yeah.
Or that condition.
The apple clanked with it there, and then he was able to get a punish after. I think that's hilarious. Okay, this is going to be a down toss bell. Okay, it's going to be a re-grab, and he's dead.
Wow, wait, Ashwin, that's so good at stalling that up. Now he's in a much better position than he was like a couple of seconds ago.
Yeah.
Double orange. Back to the ledge. I mean, it's extra credit that
this is
JDB's
153
getting.
Of extra credit.
Yeah, no,
this is almost
like
extra stock.
Terrible.
For extra
I gotta give Dashman though. You were right about that. That delayed recovery. His recovery game is insanely good.
No, that's like the one thing he's been super good at consistently. Well, he's consistently good at everything else too. But it's just like he just can't punish him like getting back on stage. It's just impossible.
Yeah, that's
Bowser wrong position.
Yeah, so much rage. You're at 124, you're Pac-Man, and now you're off the plaza.
Up tilt's a little too soon. Definitely has some Angel Plat invincibility still going. Get the jab. Oh, wow.
Oh, how are you going to say no?
Both players are like, where am I?
Ah, shield drops a little too soon there. 180%.
Now tilt's going to come out again.
Great roll.
Wow, JDB these last couple
these
times.
These catches have been really nice from a JDB, too.
Yeah.
Let me see another 200%. There we go.
You're going to see another stock, though.
Nanowatch wasn't ready for that angle from the Hydrant. I think has been jumping a lot from ledge, and I think JDB's recognition with the apple angle was really smart there.
Oh, this is going to be really big punish. Fair.
Doing a little fair
train,
but it's going to end there. Really nice parry from Nanowatch.
Yeah, cuts off JDB's a little bit short there. Ooh.
If Bowser can
punish,
build up on his stock.
JDB being a little bit too greedy.
Wow. 83? Okay.
Sure.
Oh, upbeat.
Bad upbeat.
To the sky.
Nanowatch found
him. All right, about 20%.
Yeah, but Nanowatch found a much favorable position for himself right now.
Yep, this is much more winnable than it was. I mean,
but,
yeah,
turn the carry jumping back like that.
This is so scary. Hydrant out of play. That smash is delayed, but Bowser bomb putting JDB off stage.
Yeah, it does get that Bowser.
Are we gonna see Edgar? Oh, we're going to see Bowser flame.
Great usage of the flamethrower.
Right now,
wow, I love
that. Tomahawk, but not just gonna do it just yet.
Yeah, JDB, I haven't seen him roll in a while from ledge. Bell's on play.
Oh, Bowser Flame is so nice for doing but a pack.
Wow, I love that delay.
Man, both players just delaying their recoveries. He's not getting hit. Really a good ball. Like,
Re-grab on the bell. Maybe use it to your advantage.
The Hydrant was
not
kind of
time
just in the way.
I feel like up tilt would have been a really good option for Nanowatch.
Maybe it would have sent Hydrant up and caught JDB.
Might have just been able to
nice
clip.
Run up shield.
Nice.
Bowser F tilt gonna do what it's best at, taking your fucking stock.
Landing up here just has like.
I was gonna say, Ashwin's been doing a much better job of holding center and kind of playing the stage in this last like kind of couple minutes here.
This gets him. This is what you have to do.
And it's been paying dividends for sure. Okay, that was a little bit of a
still
green
really
draft.
Scary, but no Galaxian combo for you. Oh, nice.
Landing
there.
Back
air. 66. Wait, Ashwin has rage. Oh, that flamethrower. He's 86. At 90 suddenly.
You're
well,
at 90.
Bomb. Actually,
Loki
can take it. He did the same thing. No. JDB got him. Neutral get up is not going to kill just yet, though.
But this is so scary for JDB.
But I
now.
Love the adaptation that Nanowatch has had in these ledge ups.
He's going to do it again.
JDB hasn't been getting off for
yep.
Free.
Gets up shield.
Giving Bell the respect it needs. You don't want to get knocked
like
out
JDB
yet.
JDB just keeps on doing his side. This might kill even if it's a little bit stale. Oh, not killing off the side just yet.
I gotta say though, even if Nanowatch doesn't take this
going
game,
F boost!
Wow!
There we go!
Wow!
Coming back from a deficit that nobody thought could come out of, taking 500% total that entire game.
Wow. That comeback insane. That game was almost like assuredly JDB's.
Now that
and
one was for just the God look.
Damn. Ashwin, I'm not going out like
great
this.
Great jump on ledge to catch JDB's neutral yeah. get up shield. Oh. Just catching it with the command grab that Bowser had so powerful.
Yeah.
With a lot of stage control, sends up to a very unfavorable position. Does it three times that match, by the way. Like, that's like 80% for free right there,
yeah,
which is
no.
kill percent for Bowser.
There was a point where JDB had 153% of extra credit on Bowser.
Yeah.
Literally.
Three stocks up.
No,
yeah.
like, Ashwin, phenomenal player.
That was a verse
like,
3-stock, I think,
he
right?
kept on living until, like, yes. 200%. And
no.
he wasn't done yet on
that
the third stock. He was on 150, and he was ready to go for another 50.
God,
but
he just ran up and grabbed a Pac-Man.
Nanowash literally
again.
Said, I didn't hear no bell.
He did this game one, he's not afraid to do it game four.
Yeah, no, Nanowash is not going down without a fight.
And
oh,
before we
golly.
Get into this, the respect on that bell, on that last stock, both those players' last stocks.
Yep. No, I gotta say, the way Nanowash definitely adapted with that ledge trap and just how he played around in that corner especially, just was definitely punishing some of the habits that he'd been noticing from JDB, especially with those neutral get-ups. Especially his angled recovery, too, because one thing we didn't notice with the side beast, too, that JDB was doing that first game, that really close to ledge, it was fire breathing straight down. And I'm curious to see how JDB is going to adapt around that to deal with not getting put in those scenarios again. Wow, okay, tries to go for a bit of an aggressive landing there, back to center
just
stage.
Just runs up grabs,
but
and Ashwin just does not care. Ooh, Bell just
oh,
being pushed by that, has a wind box,
oh,
it just kills! My, okay, flamethrower
carrying
that stock right there.
No, yeah.
That wind box put JDB into a really bad position. Great catch, by the way, holy crap.
Flamethrower was putting in a lot of work once Nanowash finally started getting some blood traps in.
Mm.
No, yeah, I think he had to change his way of using Flame Breath, like, you know, pretty consistently here. Okay, you ran into the hydrant, you were in the right spot.
No
Nanowash.
Fear. No fear.
That percent is Ooh. Helping him.
He's like, give me the I need more rage.
Give me the rage.
I need rage.
Oh, the F Zone kills across the entire town and city stage.
Absolutely, it does.
Bowser freaking across the entire
Come on,
town
now,
city
Bowser's
stage.
Heavy, guys. Maybe we shouldn't make
it. Oh, golly, that's a lot of damage.
Oh, okay.
Oh, good heavens.
Oh, good heavens, that's still going.
Oh, good heavens.
Good flame breath. That was
even
really,
the game,
really.
But is it really even when you and Bowser both at the same percent?
That was a good momentum breaker flame breath right there.
Yup.
Alright, gotta respect the hydrant.
Tries to go for the side B. I saw that animation come out. You're not sinking. Or was that jab? It could have been either, but
I think it was a tomahawk
greedy.
Side B there.
I like the idea. I mean, it was working last game, but I don't think I've seen JDB neutral get up shield in a very long time.
Yeah, JDB
this match.
Opting for a lot more Galaxian in this game, too.
Nanowash is abusing how fast this big turtle can be.
No,
he's just kind of running.
That guy
scary
runs.
It is. The
that
stage is shaking. He's just running at you. Falls. He just grabs you.
He is running JDB down.
Do
I
mean, you guys remember that Smash 4
care.
Trailer with Shulk in it when Bowser? Look, that guy was running fast.
Mistimes the F tilt, but does get the jump catch with the up air.
Even game, actually. I'm pretty surprised. I mean, it's already much better.
Both players going, you grab it.
Yeah, Nanowash is like, go ahead and grab that bell.
You hang up first.
You hang up first. You know what I'm about to say.
That's
a combo! Kills off the side. Town and City counter pick, kind of biting JDB in the ass.
Jab one side B, just such a nice Bowser bread and butter.
Bell's out of play. What's going to happen?
I love that jab one has that inward hitbox.
Oh, yeah. Hitbox shifts in, too.
Y'all remember that Ashwin, the Nanowash Twitter clip? Everybody just
Oh, when Nanowash innovated the Bowser meta game?
Bro, people weren't smart enough to recognize how big brain Ashwin was. Also, how bad Sheik is.
I sneezed on Sheik. Take this 80.
Death. Wow, okay, JDB kind of racking up that quick 64%.
Wow. 101, but
looks so scary. This might be the end for Nanowash, but as we see last game, Nanowash is no stranger to a clutch factor.
Oh, Bell is in play. You're at 114, and you're at ledge on town in the corner.
Yeah, you're in the corner against the Packer on the Bell, especially JDB with this
out.
Bell. Wow.
Any mistake can be a fatal one here.
I like that forward throw into the Nair to
finding
your
way.
The other option.
Nanowash almost finding his way back in. Actually, slowly gaining space and slowly taking back center, but Hydrant is also just a wall.
Yeah, no.
Ashwin is playing really safe. Just choose it.
Wow.
Whoa, just runs out of grabs.
I gotta say, though, the way Nanowash kind of played that and just slowly took control of center stage.
It's like
nobody had to
walk.
And then he just kind of sent it in a situation where JDB wasn't expecting it, got the grab, and here
we
are
in
another
situation. His placements, this is really bad. Nothing.
Hydrant fucked
up. Two punishing F tilt puts him off stage, trying to read a jump.
Yeah, be really careful here, but I like how Nanowash is kind of using
Bell
flame
back
as like
I mean, he's walking, so he doesn't get too punished. He's playing super safe. Ashwin's slowly taking control of stage. Hydrant so scary. Great
Hydrant
landing there.
Hydrant getting EWGF. Bell out of
JDB dies off the top. Ashwin to get into a game five. He's turning these impossible situations into wins.
Yeah, no, the way that Nanowash has been kind of... Yeah, actually, that was an up-air jump scare for sure.
Okay, let's be fucking for real. Nanowash just fucked JDB in the last, Nanowash like, 30 just, seconds. Like, just straight Nanowash up. Is, I like, played him in that every turn except that F-Tilt.
That's like the first two games. Bro. JDB was outplaying, and now yeah. like the script is flipped. I really like how Nanowash is kind of, from how I see, he's like kind of using like a flame breath as like, and I'm taking control of center. You know, if you walk up, you take percent. I'm using the zone. I'm using it to get rid of hydrant.
This guy fucks.
I gotta say, the way that Nanowash is playing from center, and definitely his adaptation on the ledge traps
nano
as well.
Decisions.
I just think it's definitely been really, really good to see, because that's exactly what he needed to do against this Pac-Man to be able to capitalize, make percent, and then just. Get these stocks.
That's a top player mentality. You know, when you're down that yeah. much percent, you'd be like, ah, oh, fuck, man, I can't, I gotta do something. But he just slowly walks up, shields if he needs to, shields yep. when he does, and then it just works.
Yeah, Nanowash is not afraid to kind of just work with this percent. That's gonna be yeah.
so scary.
Yeah, he's not afraid to take this percent because he's just definitely been avoiding the kill options from JDB. He's been playing around Bell incredibly well. And that's where most of the game plan comes from this character.
I almost never see Nanowash try to beat Pac-Man in the air until the Hydrant comes out.
Yeah.
But very smart by Nanowash, recognizing.
That's
oh, yep. Bell smash.
Dash Bell toss.
Dash Bell toss, so unexpected. Like, it's pretty.
It's so fast.
Yeah,
it's actually it's a jump scare.
It's literally
a
an
8-bit
jump scare.
Wow, Dare out of disadvantage right there. I really like that.
This is a jump scare matchup.
Wow, fair right there. Hydrant F-Tilt. Scary.
Really nice air dodge. Using that resource when it matters the most.
Okay, I like that. Hydrant to burn out flame for a little bit more.
The
fire breath.
Very great.
Nice little reactive ledge dropping.
Not grabbing
that
the bell.
Tries to go for the back air there to catch the jump. However,
oh my god.
Same pivot grab.
Okay.
Pivot grabbing like it's Smash Bros.
Melon.
And fist.
You know, Nanowash hasn't been hitting those.
Oh
like,
yeah, I love
those
this melon
tilts, but man, he's super good at hitting them in general.
Yeah, so once again, we're at an even spot right here in two stocks at peace in game five. Nanowash is the one on the
only
reverse 3-0.
I want to point out a little bit of an adaptation that Nanowash has. He's been flamethrowing that hydrant in the play,
yeah, no.
but he realized that like he just gets hit anyway, so he should just stop the flame breath short and shield it.
Yeah.
Just reducing the percentage he takes. It's so heavy. Like, Nanowash is heavy, right?
Yeah, it reduces.
If he reduces the percentage he takes, then he just lives for longer.
Yeah, cancels out that pressure from the hydrant incredibly well, and that's something that Pac-Mans really rely on a lot to kind of make use of the stage.
Oh,
oh wow.
What is he cooking?
Going for something real quirky there, but not able to find it. Wow. Okay, Bell's out into play now, has it in hand. JDB is kind of in the driver's seat right now.
Really
Nanowash.
Bad spot right here.
See if Nanowash can keep
how will
he
get
with
off?
JDB.
I was going to say.
Not just setting it out, waiting for that perfect moment to go.
I was
and not sugarcoat it.
And he's just walking, he's just
okay.
shooting.
Gonna say?
He's JDB. Not taking any risky options. That shield poked him!
Oh my god!
Wow, JDB!
The platforms were leaving, and I was just like, I don't think JDB recognized that the platform's gonna be on their way out, so Ashley was gonna have to be on the move, but, you know, nothing ended up happening of it, so my say was not of importance.
Your say was still valid in a way, but...
No, it wasn't!
Still got the stock.
Back here there, Ashley, what are you going for?
Oh.
There we go, that is a...
I like the just non-extension.
That's
this
fucking
step up
combo,
and call them out with that fair.
Plans out. Fruits out.
Sun's out, fruits out. What?
Nah, moon's out on this stage, bro.
That was it with Galaxian.
40 Benadryl.
40 Benadryl.
Fast
food worker, by the way.
It's fine. Ashwin's been in this kind of situation these last two games.
That was a really committal dash. Pretty
wow.
unexpected
but it was
from
really
Ashwin,
nice.
But
you just you crossed up the bell.
Nah, if Ashwin makes three comebacks.
Oh.
Nope. My bad.
I salute you, Nanowash.
I salute you, Nanowash.
That was a really...